Is a curly hair bun updo. This is my favorite hairstyle to do besides just leaving my hair down when it's curly. Really easy to do, honestly. There's just a few quick steps, so this video is not going to be long at all. And please let me know down in the comments if you guys want more curly hair tutorials. Thumbs up this video if you find it helpful. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more videos, and let's go ahead and get right into it. So this is how my hair looks right now. This is third day hair actually, and when I had washed my hair, I did a very intense moisture mask that I couldn't quite get out of my hair. That's why it looks a little greasy up in the root area, but whatever, it doesn't matter, just pretend you don't see it. Since my curls aren't as curly as they usually are, because I had my hair up in a bun for the past 2 days while I was working out, I am going to go ahead and revamp them. So what I like to use for that is this curling wand right here. This is by Cortex, and I think there was like 5 different barrels that you could attach to it. This one's the smallest one. It is slightly inverted, so the tip is a little bit smaller. Now that I do my hair curly, I find that it's really helpful because I'm able to get the exact same curls that I naturally have with this. So I have it on 370 degrees Fahrenheit. The first thing that I do is just take random pieces of hair and I'll wrap it around really quick and then let it go. So my hair is really not even on the barrel for longer than, like, I don't know, 3 seconds. And I just make sure that I'm wrapping it all the way to the root so that I can get a little bit of lift as well as a nice curl. So I just keep picking random hairs, and in the front, I do like to curl them away from my face. And then as I start going further back, I interchange. So I do some away and then some towards my face. I also like to do a few around my face because I know that I'm going to be pulling those out of the bun. And you can totally reactivate the curls with water and just kind of like re-scrunch them with a t-shirt, maybe a little bit of gel. But that requires waiting, and I, you know, don't have the patience for that at the moment. So that's why I just kind of go through and do this curling wand. I forgot to say that I do take really, really tiny sections, because the smaller sections you take, the more realistic the curl is going to look. I'm just going to let the curls cool and turn off my curly iron. Now all you need is this guy right here. Just a regular hair tie. This one's more on the thin side. I have done this before with like thicker scrunchies. It works all the same for me for thin hair. I have thin hair, but when I clip in my extensions like I do have in today, it definitely adds a lot more thin hair, but in general, just this holds my hair up very well. If you do happen to have really thick, heavy hair, I would recommend doubling or tripling up on these. So just start off with a few already on your wrist, ready to go. I'm just going to gently massage the roots with my fingers first. Loosen up the curls. And you can totally tease if you want to. I just find that curly hair really doesn't need a tease. It just needs a little bit of fluffing. So that's kind of what we're doing. I'm gonna get my part going, which I think this is gonna be good right here. I like to do a little off-center. These are gonna be my bang pieces, so we're not gonna pull those back. What you wanna do is just start taking from this tiny little area here, start slowly raking the hair back, grabbing a little bit at a time, and then adding it to your other hand back here. And I like to adjust the hair as I'm doing this. So I'm not just like pulling it all back all at once. I'm really taking the time to see where I want the hair to lay. See, it looks like I'm going to a wedding. Like I did this extreme crazy updo and I didn't even try. That's what's cool about curly hair. It's so easy. So easy to style. Okay, so now I'm just going to start adding all this hair down here to the rest of it. That doesn't matter so much because it all just kind of like gets pulled back anyway. This part is what matters the most. And I'm just holding it all with one hand, and this is the hand that has the hair tie on it. Take the hair tie and bring it around and make sort of like a little loop, a little bun with it. I'm stopping about halfway. Then I'm bringing my hand into, well, kind of into the hair tie so that I can twist it. And as I twist, I make sure that my hand goes under all of the ends of the hair, like this. Then I pull this loop this way, so that way I can bring my hand up and over and grab the loop, like that. Then, with this hand, I'm going to take the hair tie and pull that over everything, like this. Hopefully I explained that well. That was actually really confusing as I was saying it. But that's how it looks. If you want to just leave it like this and go out the door, you totally could. But I like to do little adjustments here and there. So what I do is just pull. It's all about the pulling. If you have too many loose ends sticking out, that's really easy. All you have to do is just take the loose ends, find the hair tie, and then tuck the ends in. Not the whole piece of hair, but just tuck the tiny little ends in so that you basically create like another loop, and it just adds more volume to the bun. I like these pieces here though, so I'm going to leave them. But if you want your bun to be bigger, you just keep pulling it and keep stretching it out. I'm going to keep pulling because I like big buns. I cannot lie. Now I'm just going to pull a few more pieces in the front down. Looks a lot more like romantic. And I'm just pulling from the hairline. Really like thin pieces, not too much. I'm going to do the same over here. And again, just going to go back through and make sure I got nice volume up in the crown area. I like this to be really big, and then this, I guess, big too, but I like this top area to be the biggest. Anyway, yeah, you could just like forever keep pulling and stuff. Just don't pull out the entire look, you know, just be careful how much you actually go through and pull. Yep, that's basically it, guys. I'm gonna go ahead and give you like a little 360. And I just wanted to show you guys what it looks like when I do bring it more towards the front. All you have to do is just take your hand and hold the hair back here so that it doesn't get messed up. Feel where the hair tie is, hold this hair, and then with this hand, you want to push the whole bun and the hair tie over. And then I'm just going to go ahead and tighten it up. Also, another thing, if you feel like your bun got too big and you pulled it a little too much, all you have to do is just take it and find the hair tie, push it back in. If you want to add even more drama, you can actually pull out some pieces, some random curls, just to make it look kind of like the wind kind of like undid them a little bit. If you liked this video and found it helpful, I would really appreciate it if you could leave a thumbs up down below. Also, let me know how this tutorial went for you. Were you able to recreate this look? Were you able to do it yourself? Was it easy? Let me know, and please send me pictures too. You can do it on Instagram, on Facebook, on Twitter, anywhere. I would absolutely love to see your recreations. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. Let me know what you guys want to see next, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!